Hi, I'm Sarah. In the next lab activity, we're going to look at what the chromosomes are doing in the cell during mitosis. To illustrate this process, we'll make chromosomes using beads and magnets. Let's start with a quick review of mitosis. As you know, 2N refers to the diploid state of a cell, that is, a cell with chromosomes in pairs. Chromosomes have sister chromatids before mitosis begins, because chromosomes are replicated during the S phase of the cell cycle. When a cell has replicated chromosomes, we refer to it as times two in the diagram. In mitosis, these chromatids are separated by the action of the spindle fibers, which pull the chromatids apart to make separate chromosomes destined for two new diploid cells. Okay, let's make some chromosomes. Your group has a plastic bag of red and yellow beads, and some magnets and string. The beads stand for genes, and the magnets represent the centromere. We will keep the chromosome simple, with chromosome 1 having only 3 genes on either side of the centromere. In reality, there will be thousands of genes on each chromosome. We will use red beads for the maternal chromosomes. So here is chromosome 1, that the organism inherited from its maternal parent. Recall that in a diploid cell, the chromosomes come in pairs, one from each parent. Homologous chromosomes look the same. They will be the same length with the centromere in the same place. Chromosome pairs are homologous, that is, they have genes from the same trait, but not necessarily the same version of that gene. For example, the gene for seed color could have two versions, green or yellow. We will use yellow beads for chromosomes from the paternal parent. So how would you make a paternal chromosome 1? It would look the same as maternal chromosome 1, except the beads would be yellow. The red and yellow chromosomes that are identical, except color, represent a homologous chromosome pair. To keep things manageable, we will assume that this organism only has two chromosome pairs, two chromosome 1s and two chromosome 2s. Recall that humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. The second chromosome will have two beads on one side of the centromere, and four beads on the other side, like this. A red one from the maternal parent, and a yellow one from the paternal parent. So, the diploid or 2N number of the cell would still be 4, that is, 2N equals 4. This is what the cell would have through G1 of the cell cycle. In the S phase of the cell cycle, the chromosomes would replicate, making sister chromatids like these. Note that the cells are still diploid, that is, 2N, but the chromosomes are replicated, which is denoted as times 2 in our graphic. Eventually, these four replicated chromosomes will be the single chromosomes for two daughter cells. Remember that the cell cycle consists of interphase in the mitotic phase. The M here stands for mitosis, the separation of the chromatids, which makes them chromosomes. The C stands for cytokinesis, when the cytoplasm is divided between two daughter cells. Now we want to begin the process of mitosis. At the start of mitosis, the nuclear membrane disappears, and the chromosomes become shorter and thicker. Eventually, they move to the center of the cell, where the spindle fibers will attach to the centromeres. In our activity, we will use a string to represent the spindle fibers. In order to loop the string around the centromere, pull the string through the loop to tighten it around the centromere. Attach strings in the same way to each centromere of a replicated chromosome. In reality, the replicated chromosome does not have a double centromere, but in order to replicate the chromosomes, we must use two magnets. This is a limitation of the bead model. Notice that the arrangement of the chromosomes is random, shown here as red, red, yellow, yellow, which could have been any sequence of colors, such as yellow, red, yellow, red. This means that the homologs do not associate with each other whatsoever. The spindle fibers will come together in one area on either side of the chromosomes as shown. Now with one person holding the spindle fibers on either side of the chromosomes, we will gently pull the strings to separate the chromatids, which will become new single chromosomes. At the end of mitosis, there are two daughter cells, each with the same number of chromosomes with which we began. The two cells are a result of the division of the cytoplasm, known as cytokinesis. In the next video, we will use the bead model to show how meiosis works. See you then!